Hey guys, this is Tony Solo from The Natural Lifestyles, and welcome to another edition of Ask Tony. The question I'm going to be answering today is, how and when do I get a girl's number in an interaction? Or how and when you get a girl number in an interaction? First, I'm going to start with the when. When to get a girl's number is always something that guys have this question about. You know, they're like, do I get it in the middle and then keep talking to her? Do I get it in the end and then leave on a good note? When should I do it? What I would say do is, at the time that you want to get the girl's number, get it. That's what I would say. There's not any right time, because I've done both. I've done it where I've gotten the girl's number in the end, and I've gotten the girl's number in the middle. And through all these getting of the girl's number, so to speak, that is secondary anyway. But I'm just gonna stay on this because I really wanna talk to you about, you know, you shouldn't worry about that, but I'll get to that. What I want you to do is, when you and a girl are having a good vibe, when everything is going well, do know that that is a wave of emotion that she's going through. So when you get the girl's number at the time when she's feeling good, you're gonna almost always get the number. I'm gonna be honest with you. If she is single, you're gonna almost always get the number if she's having a good feeling emotion going through her when you ask or when you say, let me get your number. Almost always. And this is the truth, because in any moment where a girl is feeling the good flow of energy between you two, it just feels right to give you the number. It just feels like the natural thing to do. So go for the number whenever things are going well, but do know that even though you're going for that number at that time, does not mean that she's automatically gonna get back to you. Because a girl goes through many different emotions after she leaves you. Man, that was a bit strange. Oh, he was really nice. I do wanna see him. She's gonna go through many different emotions from the time that you get her number till you see her. So the when, then when you get her number, it's gonna always probably be at a time where it's a good feeling going through her. And if it's not such a good feeling, what I want you to do is to persist. And this is where we get into the how to get the girl's number. And I'm gonna couple that with when to, you know, break through her resistance of giving you the number. So, how to get the number. The way I would say to get the number is, if you're just starting out, start out with just the direct way. Let me get your number. I want your number so we can meet up. Just pull out your phone and say, what is it? Do anything that's in alignment with you just taking the lead and going for the number without asking. Whatever way you want to do it, do it. Those are just some examples. Let me get your number, you know, doing the other way, give me your number. Any of these works. Now, we're going to talk about when she puts up some resistance to you. So, what may happen is that the girl may not be in that good feeling way of emotion, or she may just be a little bit on the fence about you. And when a girl's on the fence, that is what seduction is built around. Seduction is really only built around girls who are on the fence, not girls who are yes or no. It's the girls who have that, maybe, or girls who are just like, I like him, but I'm not quite that sure. This is what seduction is built for. So, what you can do in that moment is, when she's putting up resistance, is to just stay with her through that resistance. Because a lot of times, a girl's putting up resistance, and that's just a feeling wave of emotion that's coming through her in the moment. That's what's happening. She go, I don't know. This is just, you know, this is too fast. And you're like, yeah, this is really fast. You know, but giving me your number is something that is going to be beneficial for both of us. That's something that you got to have a good thing to say about. But being able to just get around a girl resistance, a lot of times just sitting there with her through it and not letting her out of that gauge of that you want her number. And James talks amazing about this on our workshop about how to do it. I'm not gonna give you guys the beans on how to do it in his way, but there's many other ways you can do it as well. And when getting around a girl's resistance or penetrating through resistance that a girl puts up about the number, what I want you to do is to start using more of truthful things when you're talking to her. You're like, you know what, this has been a great interaction. She's like, I don't know, you know, this. You're like, you know what, this has been a great interaction with you. I'm like, you think so? And getting her to say yes, she's like, yeah, but you know, we just met. Like, yeah, we did. You know, this has been a great interaction with you. And the truth is that I just want to see you again. I do. I know this may be something that's strange, but I do want to see you. And this, just you coming from that place of truth a lot of times, will be enough for a woman to say, okay. And that's the way I deal with it most of the times. Most of the times, I come completely to a place of empathy. And I just come from a place of understanding her. So that's why I say you need to stay in that gauge with the girl. Don't leave out of that container of resistance that the girl is sitting in. sit in that container with her. And when she's sitting in that container of resistance and you're standing there with her and not moving or collapsing in your presence, she's gonna feel that you really do want to see her again. A lot of girls feel that a guy doesn't want to really get to know her, or she feels that I don't know if I should see him again, mainly because she hasn't built enough trust with him. And when you sit in that container with a girl, she starts to feel more trust with you. She starts to feel like, okay, this guy is here with me, he's not moving, he's not getting angry about me saying this, he's being understanding. And that mix of being unreactive and understanding, she's gonna be able to trust you even more past that moment. Because she can see how when she says no to you or puts up a little resistance, she can see how you respond to her. And when you're responding to her in these times of resistance, now she knows, okay, along the way, if I put up resistance with this guy, he's gonna be able to sit there with me. If I give him some unknown baggage, he's gonna be able to sit there with me through this. He's gonna be able to handle my not knowing. He's gonna be able to handle my ambiguity. He's just gonna be able to handle it. And that's really sexy to a girl, because a man that's stagnant, a man that's unmoving when she has this way about her, is really, really sexy. So you can just completely come to empathy and truth when you're getting a girl's arm, she put up resistance. And a lot of times, that empathy and truth, first of all, why it works is that you have empathy on one side, and then you have truth. First, the empathy is what makes the girl more comfortable in your presence, which builds more trust. Then the truth comes out, and then that allows her to know, okay, this guy really do want to get to know me. This guy is somebody I should invest in the sense of trying to get to know. So that's the how you get the girl's number. And when she puts up resistance, that's the how you get the resistance. Now, if you want to know more about this, of course, come on a workshop or do one-on-one coaching. Preferably come on a workshop so you can get all the angles of specialties that you'll be getting from the best coaches in the world that I believe, because I'm a part of the team. And I love you guys. Stay tuned for next time to Ask Tony. And I'm here to answer all your questions. And I'm going to keep spilling all the beans and gold for you, baby. Until next time.